The Mexican Coordination of Historical and Cultural Memory, hereafter referred as Coordinación, was created in November 2018 by the current president Andrés Manuel López Obrador. The Coordination is responsible for creating a digital repository that brings together digital objects and collections regarding Mexico's biocultural, historical, and artistic legacy from Mexican and worldwide digital platforms, memory organizations, and individuals. In order to meet this aim, in February 2020, with the name of Memorica, an initial version of the digital repository was launched. The technological infrastructure of Memorica was conceptualized and created by the Department of Development and Digital Innovation, also known as DDPD, led by David Esquivel. Over the first year, Esquivel team developed a platform that would enable the collection management, aggregation, and retrieval of digital collection in a useful and sustainable way. Memorica infrastructure was built upon existing technologies which had already been tested with projects of similar scale and potential, as well as using free and open source tools, libraries, and codes. On behalf of the coordination and the head of the DPD, my colleagues and I will talk about Memorica and its current challenge. Although the DPD was able to successfully provide the basic technical structure for the digital repository, we faced with some challenges such as the lack of a strong, sustainable, and reliable network of data providers, the heterogeneous and structured data. But overall, we face with the lack of our own conceptual and semantic framework to enable the aggregation from isolated data silos. Given this scenario, Esquivel decided to enhance DDPD multidisciplinary team and scope by adding new professionals into the team and consolidating academic collaborations with experts in the fields of documentation, data models, and semantic ontologies. Therefore, in January 2020, the DDPD started a collaboration with the researcher Pedro Ángeles from UNIARTE, Instituto de Investigaciones Estéticas, UNAM. Following Ángeles' advice, the DDPD has proposed a long-term strategy based on three main aspects. One, to create a more flexible data model that can aggregate information from diverse cultural heritage and stakeholders, as well as interoperate with other information systems. Two, to build a sustainable and long-term network of collaborators. Three, to promote best practices and provide tools for building control vocabularies and ontologies. Over the next slides, my colleagues will present the current state of the model and the diverse efforts we have been making.
To be able to prepare the data and insert it into the repository, we needed to analyze the context in which the data was created, how it was created, what was its purpose, what does it describe, to which domain does it belong, is it organized, redundant, inaccurate, or incomplete. The answers to these questions gave the data meaning and coherence, allowing us to identify their features and attributes. From this first approach, we selected the core descriptive elements, the fields that should have been controlled, as well as the syntax and the structure of those which content was going to be free text. This information, alongside research and conceptual frameworks, as well as international and national cataloging guidelines, standards, and norms, resulted in a technical document that allowed us to design, organize, and normalize databases. The document is internally known as Content Structure Guidelines. These guidelines continue to develop in the extent that new objects and the data that describes them continue to enter the repository. Together with the guidelines and the control vocabulary in Tema 3, we are able to prepare the data in databases so it can be processed by the platform.
In addition to the daily data management task, with the objective of increasing the resources hosted in the Memorica repository, in recent months, we have focused our efforts on building the basis to describe those resources in terms of the semantic web. In this sense, we are working in two ways, terminology definition and resource descriptions with semantic technologies. Related with the terminology, Memorica comes with 11 controlled vocabularies with terms that have been validated by academic sources such as thesaurus, authorities, cataloging standards, and so on. Since Memorica is a repository in which new resources of different documentary typologies and different areas of knowledge are added day by day, our controlled vocabularies have been built in this context and they are being constantly updated. Nowadays, three of them, entities, languages, and places, are available through the open source vocabulary server called Tema3, where we can manage the structured databases that define relations between terms, such as equivalence and hierarchical relations. Furthermore, Tema3 exposes our control vocabularies in the SCoSCore structure through a SparkQL endpoint. We can see in the slide an example of a SparkQL query used to get the narrower terms of the artist term. In order to store our control vocabularies in IRDF triple store, we are using OntoText GraphDB. GraphDB consumes the terminology in SCoS structure from Tema3, providing to our terms RDF storage capabilities and visual representations. On the other hand, we are also looking to describe the resources stored in Memorica with mechanisms that allow to share and link our data with other related data available on the web. Up to now, we have defined a metadata specification which includes a mapping to Dublin Core elements to enable interoperability with other applications, even when using other metadata schemas, through the OAI PMH protocol. In order to enable semantic interoperability, we have reviewed in deep into the CDOC CRM bibliography, including the conceptual reference model and CDOC-based tools such as Karma, Whiskey, and 3M. Of this review, we have identified some mapping rules to move our data to CDOC CRM. In this slide, we present some of the CDOC elements used to describe a resource. For instance, the human-made object and the production class. In the following slide, we present an example of a possible representation of a resource of Memorica with CDOC CRM. It is an oil painting called La Monja Florida. It was painted by the Mexican artist Jorge Sánchez Hernández in Mexico City in 1977. We are currently working in the formal definition of the integration of our actual specification and the resource descriptions based on CDOC CRM. In technological terms, we currently have a software platform that enables the integration and management of digital collections. One of our goals is to create and strengthen communities in Mexico for better management of digital resources. Therefore, our platform development is based on the use of free and open source tools, libraries, and codes, and in providing APIs and datasets in open formats for free use. Just to conclude our presentation, I want to mention that currently we have consolidated work processes and a software platform to meet the demands of the project and the Mexican associated institutions who provide us with information on the resources they guard. And our next goal is to consolidate the work we are doing with CDOC CRM and semantic technologies in our platform to share and link our data on the semantic web.